The extremely severe cyclonic storm Amphan over west central and adjoining central parts of South Bay of Bengal moved nearly northwards with a speed of 4 km per hour during the past 6 hours, and it has intensified further into a super cyclonic storm and lay centered at 11:30 hours of today. Over the west central and adjoining central parts of south of Bengal, this particular cyclone is being moving upon, and it is very likely to move nearly northwards for some more time and then northeastwards. Hello everyone and welcome to SSB Crack Exams. I am Hemant and now we are going to discuss the daily current affairs of 18th of May 2020. Before beginning, I would like to tell you that SSB Crack Exams is India's largest, most preferred online defense exams preparation portal. It is one-stop solution for you if you are preparing for NDA, CDS, AFCAT, INET, Territorial Army and Indian Air Force Airman Group X and Group Y. You can follow us on YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, Telegram, and you can even directly visit us through our website learn.ssbcrackexams.com and download our app from Google Play Store, where you can have each and every defense exam related information content in your hands. Beginning with the question of the day that Chetan has posted as, what is the Essential Commodities Act? And the answer for that is that the Essential Commodities Act of 1955 is an act of the Parliament of India which was established to ensure the delivery of certain commodities or products, the supply of which, if obstructed owing to hoarding or black marketing, would affect the normal life of the people. That means these are those commodities which are extremely important for us, and these can't be kept under hoarding or under black marketing, which include the basic foodstuff, drugs, fuel, petroleum products, etc. So what are the generic products which are included as per the current new situations are that this particular act will include drugs, fertilizers, pulses and edible oils and petroleum products. So the center can include new commodities as and when the need arises and take them off the list once the situation improves. Currently, the 3-ply surgical masks, the meltdown non-woven fabrics, hand sanitizers are all termed as essential commodities as per the Gazette notification dated the 24th of March 2020. This is because of the COVID-19 situations we are facing currently in our country. Beginning with the first and foremost important current affairs news is that the Union Finance Minister announces several initiatives to boost the education sector. This is very important for us. Nirmala Sitharaman ji has highlighted that the education sector has taken this opportunity to plan several interventions, particularly in the area of adopting innovative curriculum and pedagogies, concentrating energies on the gap areas, being more inclusive and integrating technology at every stage to usher in a new era of focused investment in the human capital. What more, this is known as the PM E-Vidya, Prime Minister E-Vidya will be launched. It is a comprehensive initiative which includes all of these important 6 initiatives under it, which include the Diksha One Nation, One Digital Platform, the One Class, One Channel television program, where one dedicated channel will be per one grade of each of the classes of 1 to 12. That means 12 channels being live casted. So Swayam, which is an online courses for the MOOCs format, and IIT PAL is there for the IIT JEE NEET preparation, and they can even air very important lectures through community radio and CBSE Shiksha Vani podcast, which is very important for us. And then the study material for differently able development developed on the digitally accessible information system, the DAISY, and in sign language on the NIOS website in YouTube. To get in more detail is that it even includes the Manodarpan initiative, which is being launched to provide such support through a website, a toll-free helpline, a national directory of counselors, interactive chat platform, etc. Liberalizing open, distance and online education regulatory framework is a very important initiative being taken up here. A new national curriculum and pedagogical framework will be prepared, and a national foundational literacy and numeracy mission also will be launched. That is it for this particular news. Going on for the next important news is about the super cyclonic storm Amphan over the west central and adjoining central parts of the south of Bay of Bengal. It is shown in here in these areas. You can see it. It's very crucial for us, and it is very likely to move nearly northwards in this particular direction and some more time and then northeastwards too. So it even includes about the Bengal and crossed West Bengal, Hatia Islands of the Bangladesh close to the Sundarbans during the afternoon or evening of the 20th of May 2020. That means day after yesterday, day after tomorrow, as an extremely severe cyclonic storm with a maximum sustained wind speed of around 165 to 175 kilometers, gusting to 185 kilometers. What are the precautionary measures taken by the government? It includes the total suspension of fishing operations during the 18th to 20th of May 2020, all these 3 days, diversion of suspension and of all sorts of rail and road traffic. People in the affected areas will always remain indoors. Mobilize evacuation from the low-lying areas, and the movement in the motorboats and small ships is absolutely not advisable. Going on with the next in detail news is about the Ministry of Tourism. It organizes the 20th webinar titled Uttarakhand Simply Heaven under Dekho Apna Desh webinar series, and this is highlighted the potential of tourism in Uttarakhand's two regions, namely the Kedarkhand, the Gadwal region, and the Manukhand, the Kumaon region, and touched upon the popular destinations like Gangotri, Yamunotri, Badrinath, Kedarnath, Himkund Sahib, and UNESCO World Heritage Site of Valley of Flowers. Okay, going on in detail about it, even includes various adventure activities that are being carried out in that particular Uttarakhand state, and the session also presented options for experiencing the best of the nature by paying a visit to the oldest national park of the country, the Jim Corbett National Park, even including the Rajaji Tiger Reserve and the UNESCO site of the Nanda Devi National Park, exploring the rich diversity of floral and fauna of the Himalayan region. To get more in detail about each and every particular news, I hope that you even follow us through our blog, wherein which each and every news is covered in detail in specific. Going on for the next important information is that the extension of lockdown has been done up to May 31st of 2020. The states are going to decide various zones and activities are to be allowed in these zones. A new sort of set of zones, the red zones, orange zones, are all going to be set up. The certain activities are always going to be remain prohibited throughout the country. The national directives for COVID-19 management will continue to be enforced, and the night curfew will always, until and unless the government says, it will still continue to be remained in force. Next is about the finance minister announcing the governmental reforms and the enablers across 7 important sectors under the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. Around 40,000 crore increase in the allocation for the MGNREGS, the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, to provide employment boost. Increased investments in public health and order health reforms to prepare India for future pandemics. Technology-driven education with equity post-COVID. This is what I've discussed in the first news of today. So I will cover up all of the other points in detail. Further enhancement of the ease of doing business through IBC-related measures. The decriminalization of Companies Act defaults, ease of doing business for corporates, public sector enterprise for policy of a new self-reliant India, and increase borrowing limits of states up to 3% to 5% for 2021 only, and promoting state level reforms. So what are all of these that Nirmala Sitharaman ji is saying for us is about these. The first point is about the 40,000 crore increase in allocation for the MGNREGS to provide employment boost. This will help nearly 300 crore person days in total, addressing need for more work, including returning migrant workers in monsoon season as well. It even creates larger number of durable livelihood assets, including weather conservation assets, and will boost the rural economy through higher production. Next is about the health reforms and initiatives being taken up. This will include the setting up of infectious diseases hospital blocks in all the districts and strengthening of lab network and surveillance by integrated public health labs in all districts, block level labs, public health units to manage the pandemics. Further, the National Institutional Platform for One Health by ICMR will encourage the research, and the implementation will be done of the National Digital Health Blueprint under the National Digital Health Mission. Next is about the further enhancement of the ease of doing business through IBC related schemes. This will always include the minimum threshold to initiate the insolvency proceedings, which has been raised to 1 crore from 1 lakh, which largely insulates the micro, small and medium enterprises. Special insolvency resolution framework for the MSMEs under the section 240A of the code will be notified soon. So this is a very important one. Suspension of fresh initiation of insolvency proceedings up to 1 year will also be taken up depending upon the pandemic situations. Next is about the decriminalization of Companies Act defaults. This is an very appreciable thing taken up by the finance ministry. Decriminalization of Companies Act, which means minor technical procedure defaults such as which include the shortcomings in the CSR reporting, inadequacies in board report, filing defaults, delay in holding of the AGM, all of these are known as the Companies Act defaults. All of these will be considered as non-criminalized. All of these are decriminalized. The amendments will declog the criminal codes and the NCLT. The 7 compoundable offenses altogether dropped and 5 to be dealt with under alternative framework. Next is about the ease of doing business for corporates. This will include the direct enlisting of securities by Indian public companies in permissible foreign jurisdictions. Private companies which list NCDs on stock exchanges not to be regarded as listed companies. Provisions for Part 9A, Producer Companies of Companies Act 1956 and Companies Act of 2013. The power to create additional specialized benches for the NCLAT also has been done under this particular scheme of the ease of doing business for corporates. The lower penalties for all defaults for small companies, 1% companies, producer companies and startups has also been considered. Next is about the public sector enterprise policy for a new self-reliant India. Government will allow a new policy whereby there will be a list of all strategic sectors requiring the presence of public sector enterprises in the private sector enterprises in public interest. It will be notified. And in strategic sectors, at least one enterprise will remain in the public sector, but private sector will also be allowed. In other sectors, the PSEs will be privatized, timing to be based on the feasibility, etc. And it is to minimize the wasteful administrative costs. The number of enterprises in strategic sectors will ordinarily be only 1 to 4. Others will be privatized, merged, brought under the holding companies. So that is it about the 6th point. Going on with the next point is about the support to the state governments given by the central government, by the finance ministry, is that the center has decided to increase the borrowing limits of the states from 3% to 5% for the year of 2021 only. So this will give the states extra resources of rupees 4.28 lakh crore. Reform linkage will be in 4 areas, which include the universalization of one nation, one ration card. This is first one. Ease of doing business. This is second one. Power distribution, which is third one. And the fourth one is urban local body revenues. And a specific scheme will also be notified by the Department of Expenditure on the prescribed pattern. Now you have the final one, which is the COVID-19 current update in India. As of now, there are around 96,492 cases, around which there are 794 new cases have been come. The 36,824 have been recovered. The cases of the recovery has also been increasing. The deaths have unfortunately also been increased. As of now, there are 16 new deaths, amounting for a total of around 3,041 deaths. The fatality rate of the COVID-19 is 3.2% in our country and the recovery rate is 38.2%. So it is advisable for you to stay at home and always stay safe. Now it's a quiz time and the question is, which ministry organizes Dekho Apna Desh web series? Is it the Ministry of Home Affairs, the Ministry of Defense, the Ministry of Tourism or the Ministry of Environment, Forests and Climate Change? The answer for this is Ministry of Tourism. Now is the question of the day, and the question of the day for today is, what is PMSSY? The answer for this we will be giving you in the next session. Until then, stay tuned to SSB Crack Exams. Subscribe to SSB Crack Exams channel. Download our app from Google Play Store where you can have each and every defense exams related information, material, content in your hands. And most importantly, stay home, stay safe, and Jai Hind.